Good evening, everyone. I'd like to welcome you this evening to our Library and Community Service Commission. And I'm going to start reading my notes. This meeting is being conducted utilizing teleconferencing and electric means consistent with the State of California Executive Order N-29-20 dated March 17, 2020 regarding the COVID-19 pandemic. In accordance with Executive Order N-29-20, the public may only view the meeting on television or online and not in the council chamber. City meetings may be observed live at https://salinas.legislature.com calendar.aspx on the Salinas channel on YouTube at https://www.youtube.com/user the Salinas channel or on Comcast channel 25. Submission of public comment procedures. Public comments are restricted to items on the special meeting agenda persistent to California Government Code 54954.3B. Public comments generally are limited to 2 minutes per speaker. The chair may further limit the time for public comments depending on the agenda schedule. If you wish to make a comment on a specific agenda item, please join the Zoom webinar and use the raise hand icon or submit your written comment. This was probably sent out on Zoom, limited to 250 words or less via email by today at 2 o'clock to the administrative secretary, Patricia Meraz, right? Reading of public comments, the administrative secretary shall read all email comments provided that the reading shall not exceed 2 minutes and shall become part of the record. Every effort will be made to read your comment into the record, but some comments may not be read due to time limitations. Is this when we ask if there's any public comments or later? No public comments received, Patricia?
There's nothing that's been received.
Okay, so we'll move on. So can we please, I'm going to ask Commissioner Beatriz Chaides, welcome. If she could lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Yes, good afternoon, everybody. Ready? Salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
And to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, Commissioner Chaides. Roll call, Trish.
Commissioner De La Rosa.
Here.
Commissioner Camacho.
Here.
Commissioner Chaides.
Here.
Thank you. Commissioner Fong.
Here.
Commissioner Lisa Ola.
Here.
Okay, we have a quorum.
Okay, Commissioner Martinez.
Oh.
And Commissioner Izquierdo. No. Okay. Yes, we do have a quorum.
Thank you. So we're going to move on to our item. So the ID number is 22-256 and City Council District 5 Recreation Center. And we will receive a report from Kristen Lundquist, our Director of Library and Community Service. Kristen.
Good evening, commissioners. And I want to thank you all for, under a very short notice, being available for this special meeting. We have some really exciting news for you this evening, and we have some time considerations, and that's why we've called for a special meeting as opposed to doing this next week at our regular meeting. We have a great opportunity before us for the city council to allocate $8.1 million for a recreation center in District 5. And I assume you all received my staff report and have read through that. So we'll just go through this presentation quickly. The Library and Community Services Department and the Fire Department have been collaborating on the possibility of having a joint project, specifically at Laurel Park, where we would construct a new fire station along with a new recreation center and also do some additional park improvements. One of the reasons this has come forward is because on an annual basis, our state representatives ask the city to submit a variety of funding requests. You may recall that's how we received money for Hebron. $8.1 million this past year was through a direct ask through the state. And so the city has submitted a request to the state for $20 million to build the fire station and to do park improvements. But it's contingent on the city allocating $8.1 million for a recreation center piece. So between the $20 million that the state provides and the city allocating $8.1 million, that should give us what we need in order to do this joint project. As I indicated in my staff report, Laurel Park was identified primarily because of the fire department's need for their response times. And their service levels. As you know, there's a current fire station right on the corner of Laurel and North Main, poses a variety of safety concerns. And so again, moving the fire station to the park near that intersection is safer than maintaining and utilizing that intersection station. So just as a reminder, we have 7 recreation centers and they are in every other city council district, like Council District 5. So we currently do not have a recreation center in Council District 5. And allocating the funding to build a recreation center in this district in the future will provide increased access for our residents and a variety of additional recreation opportunities. We anticipate hearing more information with regard to our request from the state sometime between June and August. That's a tentative time frame. It could take longer, but that is a tentative time frame that we've been provided. The key to this is this request that goes before the city council next Tuesday to allocate the $8.1 million. We are asking them to allocate $8.1 million regardless of the state's approval of funding. So regardless of whether we get the money from the state, we want to still build a recreation center in District 5. However, if the state money doesn't come through, we need to do additional outreach and evaluation to determine what the best location is for a standalone rec center that is not tied to a joint project from the fire department. In my opinion, I don't know that Laurel would be that site if it's just a recreation center. I think we have other needs further north in that district. However, we really want to hear from residents. We don't want to make that decision for a standalone recreation center without community input. So that's my report. We're here before you to get feedback from you with regard to this great opportunity. And so I'll open it up to the commission. I'm happy to answer any questions that you may have.
Do any commissioners have any questions for Kristen? Raise your hand.
I don't have a question, but just a comment. At first, when I was thinking about it, I thought it was a great idea. But having a recreation center there, would it be a problem with like the apartments? There's a lot of apartments across the street on Laurel. And I don't know how the kids could go across with the traffic going the way it is. I guess there's a crosswalk there, but we really need the traffic to slow down so that pedestrians could get across and the kids could get across to the recreation area. So just a comment.
That's good feedback.
Yeah. I have a question on that also. So would, if the state gives the money and this is approved and the fire station, like Director Fong just mentioned, the city would look at mitigating that traffic area because it is very high risk.
I think that's something that we'd have to consider with the project. You know, part of that evaluation and developing a design for the joint project would have to involve, egress and coming and going for the fire department. So we would have to take that into consideration. I also would point out that there's, you know, a whole neighborhood on the other side of Laurel that the center would also serve. So I think your comments about making sure we have safe pathway of travel for the apartments across the street is important. And that's something we certainly can include in our comments of feedback from the commission.
Okay, very good. Any other commissioner that has a question?
A question. It's sort of like a two-part question. If the project is approved with the collaboration of the fire department, what would happen to the old building? And two, aside on District 5, I'm looking at the map right now. There, I only see two major green spaces around there, which is like Laurelwood and Northgate. Those wouldn't be conducive to adding a rec center. I'm not familiar with those park areas.
Commissioner Camacho, can you re-ask your first part of that question?
Yes, the first part was if the fire department does move.
Yeah. What happens to their building?
What happens to their building? Yes.
Thank you. That's a good question, and I don't have an answer tonight for you on that. That's something we can certainly get back to you on, and I think there would be further discussion because that is city-owned property. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that would be further development in terms of what we do. In terms of the other available park locations, I do think you're close, that those are the only two probably large enough. And if I was making a recommendation, in my opinion, Northgate would make more sense for a standalone recreation center, primarily because as of now, El Dorado Park is our furthest north recreation center, and that's where we're really missing the gap, right, of residents is north.
Correct.
So in my opinion, I would think that Northgate could be a great possibility for a standalone recreation center. It doesn't work with the joint project because the fire department has levels of service and response time goals and objectives. And so to put a fire station there tweaks the rest of their levels of service. So that's the problematic piece. But I think you're spot on. If the state funding doesn't come through, it's the, you know, bringing the residents in and having a conversation about a different location, which could be Northgate.
Thank you.
Does anyone else have a question before we do comments?
It looks like Commissioner Chai does.
Okay.
Yes. I just want to get a better understanding of the process. Read through the report. Thank you for that, Christian. So in order for the funding, I guess the proposal to be competitive, then we have to take action where the city commits to the $8 million. And I'm just trying to follow up to get a better understanding.
Sure.
Just maybe how the process itself and the timeline and so forth.
So when the city submitted its request to the state, and this is not a competitive grant process, this is just a direct request for general funds through the state. Part of that ask involved indicating that the city would allocate $8.1 million, but that takes council action. And so because of that timeline of understanding we could hear back from the state between June and August, we want to make sure that we have council action dedicating $8.1 million to this project before we get the state to say, yes, we're going to give you the money. So this is really an early process. There will be lots more involvement going forward. This really action is for council just to say, hey, we're going to take $8.1 million and set it aside for a rec center. If that, if they do that, which I believe there's support to do that, we have a lot of great options. So we're currently in the process of hiring a project manager for the Hebron Center. And the reason we selected the $8.1 million is because that's consistent with what we're doing at Hebron. And so we may be able to use very similar plans or make tweaks based on what District 5 residents want to see in a recreation center and have some economies of scale in terms of building a second facility. So we want this facility to be comparable to what we have for Hebron.
Oh, very good.
Does that answer your question?
Yes, yes. Thank you. I get a better understanding now.
Okay. Kristen, I have a quick question.
Sure.
There's two tennis courts on Laurel Park. Were we going to keep that, or was it going to be, at one time I think you mentioned that they might put pickleball courts, but I was just wondering if there's any thoughts on that.
So if we move forward with this project, the tennis courts would go away.
Would go away. Okay. No pickleball courts either.
Not there at that location, no.
Okay. Just wanted to know. Thank you.
I have a follow-up question. Knowing the department needs and sort of what has been published as far as, you know, general maintenance and current projects and the money that we don't have money for, the projects we don't have money for, what is the department's response from the community that wishes for current rec centers to be updated in the projects, though, instead of allocating $8 million to a new project for a standalone rec center?
So you are correct to point out that I think our master plan does speak to residents wanting us to care for the facilities that we have, but this is a unique opportunity to expand service in an area where we have little service. And so I think that's the reason why, and there's been a specific, we've had multiple council members talk about the lack of facilities in District 5. And so I think this is an opportunity to do something in that district. I hear your point, and I think it's well taken, and certainly something we can share.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Anyone else have a question? Or move on to comments?
I have another question.
Commissioner Titus.
Yes, thank you. So, like you said, Christina, in the early part of the process, so maybe this is something that we thought of later in different phase of the process, but my assumption is additional staffing is also part of the budget proposal or the accounting, the allocation of funds, long-term plans for, or you have existing staff that would then be reallocated, or this whole system is new to me, so I'm trying to better understand when you open a separate facility, what does that mean for, what are the implications to staffing?
Sure, that's a great question. No, there would need to be additional staffing, but I would say we are probably 2 to 3 years out to complete the project. And so we would come before the city council as we're closer to having a project complete to develop an operating budget for that facility. That could include a full-time staff member, but certainly would include temporary employees to help staff and man that facility.
Okay, thank you.
Kristen, I had a question. Why is it on this informational thing is that we don't have to make an action of recommendations? Or why did a commissioner not vote to make a recommendation?
Because we were trying to give you really more of an update. You know, the city, it's already on the agenda for city council on Tuesday. So they're the ones that'll make the formal action. And we wanted to make sure that you had the information in advance of that. And so that's why we did a special meeting versus, like I mentioned, waiting until next Wednesday to bring this forward. We wanted to make sure you heard about it prior to it going to council.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I understand that, but if we're commissioners, I think we should have a voice. We should have a vote. That's what I think. Mm-hmm. But I understand, but hopefully in the future, it's not just brought to us ahead of time, but that we do have a voice.
That's my thinking too. So with that being said, could I make a proposal to recommend going forward with the project?
Can I ask for comments? Or does any other commissioner have a question before we go on to comments and then take the vote? Is it okay, Albert? Is that okay?
Yes, fine.
Any other questions, commissioners?
Just for clarity, do we know what percentage of the Salinas population lives within this district in comparison to others?
I do not have that information at the top of my head. That's something we certainly could get back to you with.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm going to make a comment, Commissioner Camacho, on that. I worked for 40 years with public health, doing home business as a nurse. And I've had a lot of opportunities to work with residents from that area with the Salvation Army. And I'm gonna tell you something. I am amazed, Liz, how many residents live in those apartments around, not Burke Street, behind Denny's in that area, if you can ever take a ride, or around the Baranda Manor. We have a lot of low income families that live in that area, and you'll be amazed, but we need to hear those numbers, Christian, because if you talk to the Salvation Army, because they provide services, Commissioner Camacho, if you ever have that opportunity, and talk to Ezequiel Hernandez, who's running the Salvation Army, you will be amazed how many low income families live in that area. And that I'm so glad to see that, you know, that we're moving forward with this item. But if it doesn't happen, I'm glad also that we're going to take it out to the community where they'll have that opportunity to voice their opinion. That for me, for myself, I wish that we could have looked at that area over there for a community center, but it's not happening right now.
Yeah, no, and the reason I ask is, in kind of going back to my initial question, Santa Rita community, I know it feels like the voice that's always coming out of Santa Rita is that they're underserved. So that would also be an area. I know that a high school is opened up, and there's tremendous development down that way. That's also District 5. So that would be a great, you know, service for that part of that community.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And I do want to point out that all of this feedback that you're giving will be included in our in my presentation to the City Council on Tuesday. So I just want to reassure you that these comments and these themes that you're bringing up will be shared with the City Council.
Okay, very good. So does any other commissioner have a comment? No. Okay, so we cannot vote on this. Am I correct, Kristen? Or
If you want to take a vote, let's do that. We didn't set it up for an action item, but if you want to take a vote, then I can verify with the city clerk tomorrow. If you want to make a recommendation to the council, and we can let them know.
Okay.
As it, just to clarify, as it stands right now, since this is not an action item and it goes to council tomorrow, they will vote for either or, either the collaborative project with the fire department or an $8 million set aside.
No, so the ask of City Council next Tuesday is purely to set aside $8.1 million for a rec center in okay. District 5.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So.
So if you want to make a motion, I would say the motion would be that you want to recommend that council adopt or allocate $8.1 yeah. million to fund a recreation center in District 5.
Yes. So I'd like to make the motion that we recommend that the council approve the $8.1 million for that rec center in District 5. Do I have a second?
Okay, I have to withdraw my previous motion then if Gloria is going to make a motion. So I'll second her motion. But I have to withdraw my previous one.
Okay,
so we have a motion by Library and Community Service Commissioner Gloria Del Rosa, seconded by Commissioner Fong.
Yes.
Okay. Trish, can you call for the question?
Did we lose her?
Commissioner De La Rosa?
I can't hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, now I can.
Okay. Sorry. That's okay. So Commissioner De La Rosa is
yes.
calling for a rope. Okay. Commissioner Camacho?
Yes.
Commissioner Chaidez?
Yeah.
Commissioner Fong?
Yes.
And Commissioner Lisa Ola?
Yes.
Okay, it's and asked.
I have a question. Commissioner De La Rosa, as a chair, doesn't usually vote unless there's a tie, right?
No.
What?
Not in this case?
No, they all, yeah, everyone has a voting right.
Okay. I'm not sure if that's in Robert's rule of law. So you guys let me know.
Yeah, the mayor votes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I can move with Robert.
Yeah.
We'll find out tomorrow from legal.
Okay, thank you.
Right? Well, okay, so our recommendation is for them to fund it. And I just want to thank all the commissioners for being present tonight. And our next meeting is when, Kristen?
It's next Wednesday, the 11th.
The
11th. Okay, next Wednesday in person.
In person in the rotunda.
In person. Okay, next Wednesday, the 11th, in person. Okay, so our meeting is over, adjourned.
Yep. Okay, thank you.